2005 is announced as the Einstein year over the world. She would like to have your opinion of a scientist of your rank, your opinion on the impact of the science of the society on the world level now.
On the impact of the science
on the society on the world level in general. Well, what do you think the roles of science on the society now, of scientists of your rank? She is interested in this. On the occasion of the Einstein year.
Well, it is enormously important to celebrate this centenary of Einstein. And the reason is that really in all the history of Homo sapiens, from the beginning, the work of Einstein signed a very definite change in the species of the Homo sapiens. You can definitely say that there is a Homo sapiens before Einstein and the Homo sapiens after Einstein.
Beautiful. Let me translate it. Beautiful.
No, è risolto. Però c'è un altro errore che dice la maggioranza di due terzi voterà per il direttore in caso dopo due convocazioni che non sia va a maggioranza semplice, dice il testo. Loro hanno messo a maggioranza senza semplice, è un errore, quindi anche quello lo facciamo correggere. Sì, però visto che fanno quel cambiamento basta dire semplice, basta metterlo. Sì, sì. La ringrazio molto, sì. Sì, adesso stamattina finisco una cosa e poi la spedisco. La ringrazio moltissimo. Arrivederci.
Also these telephone calls are excellent. They screen excellent.
Well, I should take away, maybe.
Maybe now, yes. So you continue, maybe. I transmitted.
And well, I think you like to in English, yes, yes. And I think that we could the name of Homo sapiens maybe to add Homo sapiens Einsteinianus. when Einstein did his work in 1905, it's very interesting because the people were shocked. Not only the physicist, not only the mathematician, but also the artist. For example, we had emotional reaction in the mind of in the works of artists like Kandinsky, for example. Kandinsky work which is at the Hermitage, you can see some of this composition 16 of Kandinsky,
yeah,
which interpret some of the emotionally some of the Einstein message. And of course at the same time even in art we had in Italy Boccioni, and maybe you can put some of the images of this, some of the work of Boccioni and some of the work of Balla, and of course even all the work of Picasso was a reaction, cubism, try to understand this multidimensional world that Einstein presented. Therefore, it's clear that it was clear since the early days the enormous impact, emotional impact, of the Einstein idea. In physics, the novelty started very slow. In the beginning, we had not evidence that Einstein was really correct. There was only a very marginal experiment, or not marginal but important experiment like the Michelson-Morley experiment for special relativity and the precession of the perihelion of Mercury for general relativity. Therefore, in the beginning in physics, the reaction was not very important. It started slow.
Maybe I translate.
Yeah.
That's beautiful.
The change in physics started small, but when it happened big immediately.
An avalanche,
but very big. Because, for example, the formula E equal mc squared by Einstein, it was clearly demonstrated in a spectacular way by the bomb explosion, by the nuclear bomb explosion. Therefore, the conscience that E equal mc squared became a reality in which every politician in the world and every common person in the world was confronted. And I think this is very interesting. It's not only an avalanche, but the shock has been tremendous, even visually, about the not in the beginning was art, but then was politics.
Mm-hmm.
Was clear
the history of the century.
All E equal mc squared, which was a simple formula, which did not need necessarily to be so shocking. Therefore, the first big conscience about special relativity was the nuclear bomb.
Is physical and world changing as
there was no a politician on the planet Earth that become not primarily interested about the consequence of special relativity. Say, even Stalin, when he was put in the evidence of the first you know this anecdote that they took some plutonium to Stalin.
No.
And it was just a sphere, but
the model of the bomb.
The material, a small amount of material of plutonium. To Stalin.
Yes.
And they were scared that he would minimize the novelty.
Yes.
And then Stalin put the hand on the sphere. It was hot. Mm-hmm. He realized that was something real. And this was already equal mc squared working.
Mm-hmm.
And
yes. No, he formula. He touched the formula in some sense. Yes.
And
Person
like Stalin could consider this really a way to do something when he feels himself.
Feel himself. I mean, when politicians start to feel
himself.
This is realized that Einstein is a reality, and they cannot do without him. But now, general relativity. Did not start while special relativity was verified in 1945 with the bomb. General relativity started slower, and it's very interesting that between special relativity and general relativity there were 11 years.
Yes.
From 1905 to 1916. Now, if we take 1945 and we wait, it took more long, it took not 11 years, but it took roughly 23 years that general relativity became very important for astrophysics. And this was when, in 1971, therefore, 26 years later, was the first observation in our galaxy of a black hole, which was again something enormous from the point of view, not the nuclear bomb on the Earth were important, but for the cosmos, the concept of black hole was grandiose and very strong in a similar way.
the water sources of this second revolution in the United States. In water sources, how is in control? You understood?
Yes.
The source of the second revolution in the United States at that time. He wants you, your personal memoirs of that years.
Maybe we can take that.
Sure. Maybe later, we screen different Einstein here.
No, but this is exactly Princetonian.
Now you tell. Later they will screen this and...
Because we were a small group, not a large group, a small group of less than 10 people. And we were around John Archibald Wheeler. And John Archibald Wheeler was a man who had previously worked with Niels Bohr about the theory of the nucleus, and he himself had participated in the creation of the first H-bomb from tactical H-bomb from USA. In fact, he signed his name, John Archibald Wheeler, over the bomb of the first tactical H-bomb, testing that after the bomb, he left the field completely. And he erased from his mind the bomb work. And he went to study the most peaceful use of Einstein theory of general relativity. Good. And he changed completely. Interesting, because the style of research was also changed. I mean, in the H-bomb, he had Los Alamos laboratory, a very large number of people, technically, military implication, very large number of people working with him. But then he chose a different topic, Einstein theory, with only less than 10 young people around him, not a huge crowd, not big science, but small science. Mm-hmm. But the novelty of style of research is also interesting, because in 1968 we went in a small group, in our small group, we went to Tbilisi, to Georgia. And there we met another small group from the other side. Mm-hmm. And this other small group was also led in the Soviet Union by the father of the atomic bomb in the Soviet Union, which was Yakov Borisovich Zeldovich. Mm-hmm. And Yakov Borisovich Zeldovich had also left the bomb to start a small group of young people around him to study Einstein theory in general relativity. Therefore, we were two small groups, both born by this tremendous
explosion,
but two tiny group, and around
to start the bigger explosion,
to bigger scale. And this small group at that time were Chochotkin, Sunyaev, Biznovatikogan, Novikov, and many other young people. Yes.
Kind of return of that explosion, the best spices of humanity, how to say, they were they are returning from their dead experience to a peaceful work.
Yes. Yes, a fundamental work.
It's a Christian work to return from the, like from the scene, to be returned.
Yes.
He's saying now it means this. Returning in a biblical way, in some sense, returning to the peaceful work after this that kind of explosion.
And to not only peaceful, but more fundamental. I think this is not only a return to peace, but in a certain sense, the mind of these people to conceive an instrument like a bomb and see the explosion leave all the other aspect of social aspect, but really to understand the incredible power of science. They could feel that.
And also and the dangerous
power. Therefore, in a certain sense, they understood, they were the only one to forget about all the relevant other things and go to the substance of the very fundamental science, because they could have seen what really science could do. Mm-hmm. And therefore, they did not lose time about medals or things. No, they understood the tremendous power, and they went to the more fundamental science to start going on again.
Yes. Asma Yerenci. As a scientist of that rank, they are impressed to know about the center you have of the international scale and influence and the scale has this center in the world. So she wants you to speak a bit about the ICRA, about your center, about activity, maybe about the history and about the present culmination of the agreement and the present scientific activities.
The experience I had in Princeton was very exciting, because we saw from little idea transplanted and followed by the space missions like the Uhuru satellite, the Einstein satellite, the space telescope, how from this idea and from this new experimental work, the enormous discovery could come. And in fact, it came from this satellite, the discovery of Uhuru satellite. And this is Riccardo Giacconi in the picture of Laura Norris Causer in Rome. And you all know that Riccardo got the Nobel Prize for this discovery. Therefore, the clear message to me was that in order to have great result, you need, yes, new technology in space, big methods, but before that, you need profound theoretical idea clarifying what you are looking for and what it is. Therefore, I decided when I came back to Italy to maximize this new investment. And I started this with the foundation of ICRA, with Riccardo Giacconi, with Abdus Salam, who had later the Nobel Prize, with the director of the Specola Vaticana, George Coyne, and with Fang Lizi, who was the youngest rector of a university in China. Therefore, we decided to start ICRA with this idea to develop theory, which is more important than experiment later, but to start with US, George Coyne George Coyne and Riccardo Giacconi, but at the same time my message was to open to developing countries like China and Pakistan, and in a certain sense this was my first effort, because year before I had started this book with Fang in 1978, trying to educate the Chinese people to relativistic astrophysics.
Open the door to China.
Therefore, the idea was double of ICRA at the time. The work toward the US, advanced, and China and developing countries. Now this we have formalized an international organization, which is ICRANet, which has to do this even much more strongly.
And she's, they are very anxious to know that we have many year collaboration with you, and especially this collaboration is presently developing even more with this opportunity. So she wants your opinion.
Well, my relation to Armenia, of course, we know that the relation between Armenia and Italy dates for a long time, because in 66 after Jesus Christ, the King Tiridate came to Rome to be in the Colosseum to be elected King of Armenia by Nero. Therefore, we have at least 2,000 years of collaboration between Italy and Armenia. In my special case, I start to learn about Armenia because one of my closest friends in the university when I was a student was an Armenian, Keshishan was his name, and he was studying chemistry, not physics. Oh. But we were very close friends, and he came often to my home. He knew my father, my mother, and Misak Keshishan had also a brother who was now is a big bishop in Armenia, and Misak introduced me to the problematic of the Armenian people and the fact that there was San Lazaro Island. Therefore, in a certain sense, I was introduced to this reality of Armenia by this good friend. Right. Perfectly acquainted about the greatness of the relation between Rome and Armenia, and in fact, every time I cross going to the Colosseum and you see the map of the Roman Empire, I was always interested in that white part in toward Asia in which Armenia is in the map. And maybe you should ask them to take. Yes. Yes, Armenia was very important because there was the school of Abartzumian. And in the school of Ambarzumian was well known all over the world. And the first time that I met with Gurzadian, with Vae, was in Australia at one of our Grossman meetings. Mm. And I was therefore well prepared to appreciate his very great knowledge who had acquired in the school of Zeldovich and in the school of Ginzburg in Moscow, and we started to collaborate immediately at that time. And the collaboration became more and more strong, and he started to visit us very often with the year going, until the realization of ICRA came, and the fact that we needed three nations to become the starting of an international organization. We decided to start. There was a rationale. Of course, it would have been easy to start with the organization with the big nations. But we decided the opposite, to start with some important university in US, Stanford and the University of Arizona. Mm. But a state to start with small states, not to polarize the structure of the organization, because otherwise it will be taken under a totalitarian rule by one country, or either one or the other one. And we decide to choose the nation with the highest ratio between science in astrophysics and population. And of course,
per capita.
And per capita, certainly one of the most important is the Vatican, because sure, they have very big observatory and very small population. And Armenia in the former Soviet Union was certainly the republic with more astronomy per capita.
Yes, definitely.
And therefore, this was really a small country, but very prepared intellectually, and again open to developing country and advanced country.
You are also scaling. You are mentioning about this. She's saying, I want to have also one philosophical question, if possible, if she's permitted to use the opportunity. She's saying, do you hope that the scientists, particularly astronomers, can stop the dangerous science in the society? Into the dangers which exist in the world, the wars and all these cataclysms. Can the scientists or astronomers somehow stop this, influence this?
I think the first thing to understand is our position in the universe, because I think the majority of politicians today are so much looking at the interest, local interest, economical interest of the small society, but they never look at the universe,
the present moment,
of the present moment, and of their own groups, of their own tribes, without understanding the overall picture and the solitude which we have in the universe, the solitude. This is the point. And a big step making these people realize the delicate equilibrium over which life,
and the uniqueness of
the
life.
Uniqueness of life, and the delicate balance of the possibility of having life on this small planet. And understand also that this is just a transient state in the universe itself, which has a beginning and evolution, and there are very few places like this, and it's very tiny in the universe as an ensemble. Astronomy, astrophysics can make a very, quite apart from the discovery, a very big step in educating people to this status, which is the real status of man. The politicians do not understand the real status of man. They are just focalized in the very strong dispute and attack, but they don't realize the overall picture, which is of an extremely beauty, but of extreme fragility. And unless we don't understand this, we will make enormous. We will not be Homo sapiens. We will be just people, like Einstein used to say. I will tell you a phrase by Einstein next.
Beautiful.
I think Einstein said, I don't know how the Third World War will be fought, but I'm sure about the way the Fourth World War will be done, is with the clava. You remember that?
Yes.
Yes.
And before meeting you, from Professor Buzadzano, we had some image of you, of scientists, and now she said, really I understood how influential and how really large scale thinker you are, and confirmed in some sense the image we had. So it is, I think, complimenting. And she is saying so, but even knowing all this, we are really impressed what we heard now, and we are we also know that and expect that soon you will arrive in Armenia.
Oh yes, yes.
She is waiting you to meet there. Usually they say that all the talks are have to be continued. And so we hope that this conversation will be continued there.
Thank you.
This was fascinating.
So they are waiting you there.
Thank you.
But now we can go and see.
Yes.